Hello students, how are you all? Hope all are fine. Today we are going to discuss our fifth chapter, that is A Trip to Andaman, grammar part, that is the simple past and past continuous tense. Before going to simple past tense and past continuous tense, we have to know the meaning for the tense. Here is the definition to the tense. A tense is a form of a verb which tells us a time of action. Once again, I'm reading the definition. A tense is a form of a verb which tells us time of action. So here, based on the verb, we can decide when the action was done. Based on the verb, this is the main important thing in a tense. For example, I am going to school. Second one, I was going to school. Third one, I will be going to school. Observe these three examples. The three are going to school, going to school, going to school, and the subject also same, but the helping verbs differ. We'll see in the detail. Hope you observed the previous examples. I am going to school, I was going to school, and I will be going to school. Here, types of tenses. First one is present tense, second one is past tense, and third one is future tense. The first one, present tense. Verb action is happening now. Just remind the previous examples that I gave you here also. I am going to school. I am going to school means here, this action is happening now at the present time. And the second one, past tense. Work is already done. Example, I was going to school. Going to school is already happened in the past time. That's why we used was as a helping verb here to show that the work was already done in the past. So the definition for the past tense. Work is already done. And the third one is future tense. Work will happen in the future. For example, I will be going to school. So, in the first sentence, that is happening now. In the second sentence, it's already done. In the third sentence, it will happen in the future. Maybe it's tomorrow or day after tomorrow or after a month or after a year. We don't know. So that is the future. These are the three types of tenses we are using to write or to prepare sentences. Students, here is our topic, simple past tense. Before going to simple past tense in detail, we have some glance about this past tense. I already gave you a small definition about it. Past tense means the work is already done. It was done before. So, here the past tense again have four different types. One is simple past tense, which we have now. And the second one is past continuous tense. And third one is past perfect tense, and fourth one is past perfect continuous tense. Not only the past tense, the present tense and also the future tense has these four types. Let us see our first one, simple past tense. Here is the principle for it, how to write a sentence by using this simple past tense. Subject plus V2 plus object. This is the principle to write a simple past tense. Let us see the definition. It is used to express an action which completed in the past. Again, I'm reading. It is used to express an action which completed in the past. Means here the action which was completed already in the past. Means it was done. The work is already done in the past. Here is a note. Following words are used in simple past tense. Yesterday, last night, last week, earlier this week, ago, last month, in 2010 or year. Not a particular 2010, we have to mention the year, the previous years we have to mention in the past tense. Based on the definition of simple past tense and the note, the words which were given before already, please keep in your mind. Here are some examples. We just go through them. First one, Ramu went to Hyderabad last night. You can see the principle here. Ramu is the subject. Ramu is a subject. Here you can see Ramu. Ramu is a subject and went. Went is a V2 form. Where he went? He went to Hyderabad. Hyderabad is a object. So here subject plus V2 plus object. You can see subject plus V2 plus object. This is the principle to prepare a simple past tense. Let us check the sentence again. Ramu went to Hyderabad last night. Last night means it's already completed. Last night, Ninna Ratri. Then we'll go to the second one. What is the second one? Just observe. Same thing. The same principle. I is the subject. Sa V2. A film. It's an object. Likewise, we have these many examples. Let me check one more thing by using our marker. We'll see. Randomly we select 7th one. Okay. What is this? It is a subject. Came. This is a V2. Here there is no object. No issues. That is, the basic principle is subject plus V2. And yesterday here mentioning that it was a completed action. So, we can observe all the examples once more here. Ramu went to Hyderabad last night. I saw a film last night. I passed my MA in 2019. In the note, we mentioned in year. Right? Here, in that note, we gave 2010. Here, the year is 2019. Fourth one, they played cricket yesterday. Fifth, you worked very hard last month. Sixth, she wrote exam. Seventh, he came yesterday. Eighth, she met me last month. Ninth, he bought a car last year. Tenth, they came to me a week ago. So these are the examples about simple past tense. Hope you understand these examples. Students, After getting some idea about simple past tense, here is your grammar part from your textbook. Simple past tense. Read the following lines taken from the lesson. Soon after the examinations were over, Mom made preparation for the trip. On the 25th of April, we took the Pinakini Express from Vijayawada and reached Chennai at 1 p.m. The underlined words are the verbs in the simple past tense and refer to actions that took place in the past. The simple past tense is used here to talk of completed actions in the past. We already discussed about the principle for the simple past tense. Here you can see the underlined words. Just implement the principle here. Examinations, that is the subject, were, we took. Next, Mom made. Here, Mom. Mom here, what is this? It is a subject. Made, it is V2 form. What she did? She made preparation for the trip. And the second one here, third one, sorry, V. It is a subject. Took, V2. The Pinakini Express, this is object. Next, from Vijayawada and reached Chennai at 1 p.m. Based on the principle, we can easily identify the simple past tense. Hope you are clear with this. Here is an exercise from the textbook. We'll read out once. Given below is the action plan prepared by the headmaster of Jilla Parishad High School, Kutbullapur, for a tour to Nagarjuna Sagar project. They finished the tour on 15th October. Describe the tour in the past tense by making appropriate changes in the verbs given in the action plan. Let's see what is the action plan is here. At 6 a.m. board the bus at the school. 8:30 a.m. stop at the Chintapalli. 12 p.m. noon reach the spot. 1 p.m. take lunch. 1:30 to 3:30 p.m. visit the Nagarjuna Sagar project. 3:30 to 4:30 p.m. visit the museum. 4:40 p.m. visit Ettipothala Falls. 5 p.m. board the bus. 8:30 p.m. take supper at Chintapalli. 10:30 p.m. reach the school. Here they are clearly mentioned in the question last line. Describe the tour in the past tense by making appropriate changes in the verbs given in the action plan. Here I have selected the verbs which we have to change into the past form. Let's see. In the first one, at the 6 o'clock, board the bus at the school. So that is changed into boarded. The second one, stop at Chintapalli. That is a stop is a present form. We change it into past as stopped. And at 12 noon, reach the spot. Reach changed to reached. And at 1 p.m., take lunch. Take changed as took. And 1:30 to 3:30 p.m. the verb is visit. The past form visited. So in the remaining times the same verbs are repeated. That's why I gave only 5 verbs here. They are changed into past tense. Students, try to complete this. You can start like this. On 15th October, the students of JPH School, Kutbullapur, started their tour to Nagarjuna Sagar project. They boarded the bus at the school at 6 a.m. Could you identify this? They boarded the bus. I already gave you the past form for the board. Here the boarded was used. Try to finish this paragraph. Students, here is my version. Hope it will be useful to you. But please prepare your version too. On 15th October, the students of JPH School, Kutbullapur, started their tour to Nagarjuna Sagar project. They boarded the bus at the school at 6 a.m. After 2.5 hours, they stopped at Eluru for breakfast. After having breakfast, they continued their journey. At 12 p.m., they reached the spot. All the students felt happy by seeing the Nagarjuna Sagar project. There, they took lunch. After having lunch, they visited Nagarjuna Sagar project museum and they also visited Ettipothala Falls. At 5 p.m., they boarded the bus. Around 8:30, they took supper at Eluru and reached the school at 10:30 p.m. You can observe the verbs here in this paragraph. The students of JPH School. This is the subject. The student of JPH School. Of course, the school name is Kutbullapur. This is the subject. And started. This is V2. What is the V1 form for this started? Yes, that is start. V2 form is started. And in the second sentence, they is the subject here. Boarded. This is V2. They boarded the bus at the school at 6 a.m. After 2.5 hours, they stopped at Eluru for breakfast. After having breakfast, they continued. Again, observe the V2 forms in this line. At 12 p.m., they reached the spot. Students, please find out subject plus V2 form in this paragraph. Hope you understood this. After simple past tense, we have the next sentence, that is past continuous tense. This past continuous tense principle is subject plus was or were plus V1 plus ing form plus object. Let us check the definition for the past continuous tense. It is used for an action which begins in the past and going on sometime in the past. Once again, it is used for an action which begins in the past and going on sometime in the past. So, both were the beginning and the ending of that particular action is in the past tense only. If the sentence starts with a singular subject like I, he, she, and it, the helping verb was used. If the sentences start with the plural subjects like we, you, and they, the helping verb were used. Here is a note for the past continuous tense. Past continuous is used with the combination of two tenses. First one is past continuous, second one is simple past tense. Again, check the note. past continuous is used with the combination of two tenses. First one is past continuous and second one is simple past tense. Examples: She passed intermediate while I was studying 7th class. Again observe, here two sentences are there. One is in simple past and second one is past continuous. We already checked that note. The continuous tense will be in the combination of simple past tense. That we can see here in these examples. First one, she passed intermediate. She is a subject and past be to form. So here the simple past tense is given in the first part of the sentence. And in the second part, I was studying 7th class. I is a subject, that is a singular subject. Was is a helping verb we are using here. In the second one, Swami was teaching English. The first part of this second sentence is in the past continuous tense. Swami was teaching English when I went to the college. Third one, they were praying God when police went to their house. They were. Here they means, that is a plural subject. That's why we used were as a helping verb in this sentence. They were praying God when police went to their house. In the first part of the sentence is past continuous tense. And in the second part of the sentence is, that is simple past tense. And the fourth one, Deepika knocked the door when I was watching the TV. Deepika knocked. This is simple past. And second part of the sentence, I was watching the TV. This is the past continuous tense. This is from your textbook, Past Continuous Tense. Read the following lines taken from the lesson. Some foreign tourists on the beaches were basking in the sun and enjoying themselves. The underlined verbs were basking and were enjoying are in the past continuous tense. The past continuous tense is used to talk about or describe an action which someone was doing or an event which was happening at a particular time in the past. As we discussed before, you can observe the first line. Some foreign tourists on the beaches were basking. Basking here. Some foreign tourists. Here is the plural one. That's why were basking. The helping verb were was used here. So, all these actions were done in the past. Some exercises from your textbook. Let us check once. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate forms of the verbs given in the brackets. See these questions in your textbook and try to answer them by using the words which were given in the bracket. In the first one, they dash with each other when the police dash. Here the verbs are fight, arrive. This is in simple present and past continuous. Please keep these two tenses principles and also the conditions in your mind and prepare the appropriate verb form and write in the blanks. Second one, when Rajesh dash, he dash down and dash his leg. In the given bracket, run, fall, injure. Third one, while he dash, it dash to rain. In the bracket, the verbs are play, begin. Fourth, the children dash a film when the lights dash off. Verbs, watch, go off. Fifth one, my mother was dash when the guests dash. In the bracket, still cook. Next one is arrive. Then sixth one, the teacher dash when the principal dash the room. The verbs, teach, enter. Seventh one, father was dash the TV when the telephone bell dash. Verbs are watch, ring. Eighth one, we dash ready for our journey when the power dash off. The verbs are get, go. Students, try to fill these blanks. Here are your answers for the previous textual exercise. First one, they were fighting. They is a plural subject. That's why we are taking were as a helping verb to fill this blank. They were fighting with each other when the police arrived. The first part of the sentence is in the past continuous tense and second part of the sentence is in simple past. Second one, when Rajesh was running, he fell down and injured his leg. Here three verbs are given. First one, was running. Why we took was here? Yes, Rajesh is a singular subject. Third one, while he was playing it, began to rain. Fourth, the children were watching a film when the lights went off. Fifth, my mother was still cooking when the guests arrived. Sixth, the teacher was teaching when the principal entered the room. Seventh, father was watching the TV when the telephone bell rang. Eighth, we were getting ready for our journey when the power went off. Students, hope you got clarity about simple past tense and past continuous tense, about their structure, about their usage, and the examples clearly. Thank you, one and all. We'll meet in the next class.